Everybody, this is Shobit. So guys, in this video I will deploy a .NET Core web application inside a Docker. So for that I have already created a web application. So here the Shobit-1-demo is application which I will deploy inside a Docker. So the only thing you required is Docker is up and running on your machine. Here you can see Docker instance is running on my machine. Okay, so I'll start with the Docker file. So Docker file is a backbone of this project, because with the help of this Docker file we will create image, Docker image, and Docker image, after that we will create a container from the Docker image. So this is the backbone of this file. If you are using Visual Studio, Visual Studio will give this file out of the box, but if you are not using Visual Studio, you need to write this file. So I will give you a little bit insight about this file. So what is this? So here you can see the line number 4. So we are getting the image of nano server, and we are going inside the app directory and exposing the port number 80. After that I will use the same image and copy the content of our project inside this working directory, and further I will execute the .NET restore command, and after that we have to go with the .NET build command in the release mode. After that another build is required for the publish. So this image is for the publish, and the final image is basically we are copying the content inside the publish image and put inside the app folder, and finally we'll specify the entry point. So entry point means whenever you start a container, this command will execute. So this command will launch our web application. So this is for the Docker file. So with the help of this Docker file, guys, I'll create image. So the image is, you have to go first inside the command prompt, and the command for creating the image is docker build, and the name and the t is a tag, and after that you have to give the name. So I will give the name of this abc and the dot. So once you do that, you will see over here it created successfully. So the image has been created successfully. So I need to check whether it is working or not. So the command of getting all the images is docker images. So here you can see docker abc images there. Okay, fine. So from this image we will create a container. So the command for creating container is docker run minus d is for detach mode, minus p is for the mapping. We have to specify the port mapping. Basically the port is, I will go for the port number 9004 my application, and the container port is port number 80, and the image name. So finally you can see this docker container is running because I'm getting this ID. So if I open the port number 9004, so you can see my web application is up and running in port number 9004. I can create as any container over here. You can see I'll specify the port number 9006. So the same application is up and running on port number 9006. And so after that, basically, if you want to stop this application, you just need to copy the port, the command container ID, and the command is docker stop and the command. So here in this port 906 stop. So if I execute the refresh it, you can see this is not up and running on 9006 port. So guys, this is for all the demo, and if you have any question you can ping me. I'll specify my email ID in the description box. Thank you for watching this video.